Hello and welcome. My name is Xander. Welcome to the ORM Mastery course, Level 1 for Beginners. In this tutorial, we explore the concept of a one-to-one relationship, building or defining a set of fields that represent relationships using the one-to-one relationship. Just briefly, for anyone new to this playlist, this tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. And then finally, before we start the tutorial, if you liked this tutorial and would like to learn more, please check out our Django Database ORM Mastery course on Udemy. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Course thumbnails may change over time, so please check out for Created by Very Academy. In the previous tutorial, we took a look at how to build a foreign key. And you can see our set of tables here that we're going to be utilizing throughout this first section of the course, level one. You can see it has many different foreign keys. Now, something that I've tried to also model is a one-to-one relationship. So this type of relationship, we are essentially saying one item in the stock, one record in this stock table is related to one record in the product inventory table. And then one record in the product inventory table is related to one record in the stock table. So we have a one-to-one relationship. So we need to define which side the one-to-one relationship is. Although, yes, in this case, it's going to be the stock table. So here we have a one-to-one. I've defined it as a foreign key here because essentially it will be very similar. So let's go ahead and we're going to build a stock table in this tutorial, and we're going to connect it to the existing product table that we created in the previous tutorial. So let's go ahead and define a new table. So let's just put it underneath the product table here. So class is going to be stock, and then like we've been doing here, we've been extending from models.model. Okay. So let's go ahead and bring in, for example, something relevant. Well, what we're going to do here is define, let's have a look at some of the fields, actually, last checked. So let's go for units. Okay, let's go for units first. Units equals model dot, maybe some sort of big integer field. And then we'll go for the actual one-to-one reference. So here, this is going to be called product. So product equals, and then we need to define this now as a one-to-one relationship. The difference being here compared to the foreign key is essentially we're going to define models dot and then one-to-one field. So now we need to, like the foreign key, just define the relationship or the related table, which is going to be product. We can also define, like the foreign key, the onDelete behavior. So let's do that. So on delete equals, and then let's just go for a cascade again. So again, the principles are the same as the foreign key, like we learned in the previous tutorial. So you'll need to think about how you want to define your one-to-one relationships, because ultimately with cascade, you will potentially lose data. If you delete any of these stock items, it will cascade, the product items, it will cascade to this stock table. Now here it kind of makes sense, because if we don't have a product, then we don't have any stock, we don't have any units, there's nothing to record. So in this case, with our cascade being defined here on our foreign key, whenever we delete a product item, it will also delete the corresponding stock items that are related to the product via the one-to-one field here. Let me just finish this off. So it should be models.cascade. I should get rid of the error. Okay, right, so let's now go ahead and into our admin. Let's just add this to our admin so we can just quickly have a look at it, in action, stock, okay. So we are going to need to migrate, of course, because we've just added some new information here. So Python 3, manage.py, make migrations, and then we go ahead and migrate. Okay, so now we can start the server again and we should be good. Right, so let's go back into the admin area And now we have the brands. So now we cannot make, stock. So in order for us to build a stock item, we need to make sure that there is a product item. So let's go ahead and add a product item. Now we can't build a product item unless there's a category item. So you can start to see how these tables are now related and relevant. So let's go ahead and create a category. So cat one, and then our product. So let's just call this product one. It's going to be connected to our category here. Let's press save. And now we can add a stock item. So add some stock, some units. We've got 100 of the product one, and press save. So let's just see this in action on the cascade. So if I go ahead and I delete this product, press go, you can see that we are also going to be removing the stock as well. So if I press delete here, it would remove all the products and then the stock that's related to that product. Now I'm not going to do that, take me back, because what I'm going to do and have a look to see what happens when I delete categories. Remember, categories are connected to products and products are connected to stock. So technically, if I delete this category, it should delete all the products and then the stock associated to those products. So let's take a look. So you can see that is going to be the case. It tells me what's going to be deleted, the category, the product, and then the stock item. Yes, for sure. And you can see now I'm back to where I started with no products. So the question might be here, what makes a foreign key different from a one-to-one relationship? Well, here, for example, in the product and category relationship, foreign key relationship, the foreign key here can be duplicated. So it doesn't need to be unique. Because remember that for one category, there can be multiple products. So for example, this category can be one for multiple products. This might be category shoe, and that might be stored in multiple records in this table. So if in this situation, our key here that we defined a one-to-one relationship, this must be unique. So we can't have one stock item connected to multiple products. So there should be one stock item connected to one product. So our product or our one-to-one field has to be unique. So let's just see that in action. Let's go back to the admin and then we'll go ahead and add a category. Call this cat one and then products. Add it to the category. And then let's go ahead and add a stock item. So units and product. So let's now try and add a new stock product to the same product. You can see here that we get an error because we have a one-to-one relationship. So we cannot add multiple stock items that are related to multiple products. So we have to have a one-to-one relationship. So one stock item is related to one product.